ওই যে গোল হাটটা দিয়েছিল না এই মেয়েটা, মনে আছে? গোলার হাত খুলে দিল না আপনাকে, ওরা ওর প্রতি দুজনে মনে করছে।
দে শুড ম্যানেজ টু টেল what should be done first, first and be after that.
Yes. Just same program as we are doing at house, and most devotees are also same.
Yes, all are the same.
A few extra, but most all same.
So much place here, all can come. Jai Dhvani first, then Vandana. Jai Dhvani.
Jai Dhvani Vandana.
Jai Dhvani, you have done?
Yes.
Oh, then. Then Vandana. You have given jai of all the Guru Parks, no. Swamiji and all others. No? So you should do. Who will do? Who are senior, they should do. You can do.
Jai Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pad Paramahans Paribraj Vicharya Astra Tarasatya Kumad Bhai Charanara Vinda Bhakti Vidanta Swami Shri Prabhupada Varsha Upavana Ki Shri Shyama Kunda Radha Kunda Jamuna Ganga Tulsi Bhakti Devi Ki Shri Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Ji Ki Jai Charodham Ki Jai Sarasampraday Ki Jai Charocharya Ki Jai Matra Matra Shri Chaitanya Mat Ki Jai Shri Kesha Vigori Mat Ki Jai Shri Chaitanya Sarasat Mat Ki Jai Shri Krishna.
No, Bandana. As you begin, Namo Vishnu Padayo, Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namine, as you begin and do Kirtan, begin from there.
Namo
Siddhanta Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya
Srimadev Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Iti Nama.
Again.
Thank you.
Hari. Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha, Jaya Girivara Dhari, Jaya Girivara Dhari. Jana Vallabha Jaya Girivara Dhari Jaya Girivara Dhari Jaya
Thank you.
Padmanande Sri Radhe Jai Jai Sri Radhe Jai Jai Sri Radhe
ज्ञानञ्जन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमः We know that in this world everyone wants happiness. For this, they do everything from sunrise to sunset. Anyone does not want unhappiness. Anyone don't want to be old. Anyone don't want that their hair should be white. They don't have to face any problem in this life. They want pure happiness. They want this, but they have to suffer so much. They do as they can do to become happy. But the real fact is that they will have to be old. They will have to be weak and suffer, and at last giving this body here. To make happy this life of everyone, we know that only we are men. We people. But we don't think that trees, creepers, animals, birds are also living entities. They don't know. So they want to kill them and to take their eggs, flesh, blood, everything. Even serpents and so many poisonous things, they take. As if Krishna, God has created this world, that you should kill all and take and be happy. But by this thing, anyone cannot be happy. Only wealth, money, beautiful body, intelligent mind, strong body cannot make a man happy. We read in papers that the Prince of Wales, so wealth, so beautiful he is, also he married a very beautiful girl, Diana or what? He has so much wealth and everything, very good palace, king-like palace, everything. But he could not become happy. Diana left him with their child, with her children. Now he feels unhappy. Also his ex-wife feeling so much unhappy. We know that in previous time in India, in Lanka, Sri Lanka, there was a very big king named Raman. All the palaces in whole Lanka were made of
gold.
Goddesses used to broom their rooms. They were so much powerful that any goddess have not dared to go there. He has 1 lakh of sons, very strong. They can change their body in air, in horse, in beautiful any women. What they want, they you could do. Everything. So they wanted to rule whole universe. They were not satisfied by this. They wanted to rule whole Bhuvasa, Hama, Jana, Tapen, what looks are your sun, moon, everything. They used to go all the planets without any without any plan or anything. Fly at once and go. One moment. They collected everything to be happy. They collected all the things that we cannot imagine even. This made them more mad. More
unhappy.
More problems. And that is why at last Balaram, he himself with his all sons and nephews and his all family accepted one brother who was devotee of Ram. All were killed there. The whole golden houses were smashed in and burned into ashes. There was none in Lanka to be happy. Also I know a person in India, he was more than him, Ravan, and that was Hiranyakashipu, the father of Prahlad Maharaj. He took a benediction from Brahma, the creator, world creator, that I should not die in day or in night, in any month, in sky, in lower lokes, on earth, not I should die in anyone should not kill me with weapons or anything. He should not die in any month, not inside room, not in outside of room. Thus he became like
immortal.
Like but not. And he began to atyachar karna devotees par. He began to rule our whole world and began to
harass
all the devotees. All the devotees. He began to slaughter so many lakhs and lakhs cows also. Everything. Where the devotees are suffering by anyone, in which kingdom cows are slaughtered, green trees are cut down,
cow,
and others bad behaviors to all, no love affection for anyone there is, that it is the downfall, it may be very soon downfall of that thing. And he will be, dhans uska ho jayega, he will
ruin
that all. So, such a powerful person was killed in a moment. You know all these things. He could not be happy. Nowadays, we seen in Yuktarashtra. Yuktarashtra means?
United States.
USA.
USA.
No. All the big, intelligent persons. They used to make so many programs that whole world should be happy. No war, nothing. But they cannot control. Scientists. They have invented so many new things from kitchen room to medical and all other things. Now they can change the heart. If it is damaged, they can manage to again give any monkey's
brain
also. If anyone died, they will take their eyes and they will give in other blind persons also. So development everything. They can go from one part of other part of world very soon. They can be in here, in Australia, in eastern part of world. They can see even a match, cricket match in America, opposite to this, and in Western countries, and they can make bombing here and there if their country is
attacked by another country.
Winning the match.
If they win match, then they begin to hell bombs here and there, jumping here, then
cracking
everything. In a moment they will know. We can speak from other part, Antarctica to also Arctic sea persons here and there. Now you are trying to go to moon and other
planets.
Only to be happy, but problems are increasing and they are on the same stage where they were in lakhs and lakhs year before, more problems coming. You know what is the now problem? The problem of this new civilization, and by discovering so many things, we are gaining something. And it is a very strange thing for all. But on the next hand, we are losing whole thing. What that thing is? Love and affection for anyone. Now in this stage we cannot love our wife so much. We cannot trust on them. No belief, and that is why the separate
bank account.
Account in banks are separate. If he will cheat, if she will cheat, also the girls littles and their sons have no faith on their father and mother, and they make separate accounts. we know in Calcutta and Bombay, that in a flat, thousands of persons live there, thousands of family together, but they don't recognize each other. One family weeping, his husband is died, their husband is, or anyone has died, they are weeping, and in the next, never. So much enjoying, dancing and in nightclubs and everything. In a great, in a very so much crowded road, we have seen in Calcutta and Bombay, lakhs and lakhs persons are going and coming in so hurry, running there. If a man anyhow injured and
falls down,
so injured, anyone has no time to give, to take care of that person. They fear that if we will go and ask that person that what happened and we will try to help, police will also come and harass them. Our other party may shoot us. Anyone has not time to give any support or help. So there is no, this is the problem of whole world, that now no affection here, no love. How it can? How we can solve these questions? Only it can be solved. We can follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Harir Nama Iva Kevalam, Harir Nama Iva Kevalam, Kalau Nasti Nasti Vigatiranyata. If we have a mood to serve Krishna, Supreme Personality of God, and we have some affection for Him, then certainly a love and affection for everyone, trusting each other, it will come easily, otherwise not. Lakhs years spent, where Hiranyakashipu was there, Ravana was there, is there, we are in the same platform, hankering for peace, hankering for happiness, but we are all in the same stage. So if we have love and affection, and we will try to love and serve Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is creating this world, who has given this beautiful body, so intelligence, everything he has. He is controlling sea, he is controlling sun and all planets, not to
collide
themselves, and thus ruined the whole world. We are eternally servant of that person, God. So God has this meaning, G-O-D, same meaning in Bhagavan, G generator, O
operator,
D
destroyer.
He. Who is he? We are not. I have heard that Hitler wanted to destroy France, England, Russia and all countries. But he was finished himself. Ravana also, and all demons like this. So, if we want to be happy forever, we should know that all the living entities, whether they are tree, creepers, animals, birds, man, goddess, and anyone, all are eternal servant of that God. So, if we pray Krishna, if we call by doing Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
He is Sarvajna, he is
all knowing.
What has been done in past, now what is going on, and what will be in future. Everything he knows, it is all in his hand. But in the same time, being supreme power, he can do anything he like. But at the same time, he is so merciful. Bina karan ka, ahetu ki?
Without any cause.
Causeless merciful. If you have done anything wrong, and you call him, oh Krishna, I will never do like this, like Jagai Madai. I'm giving up all the things, bad things. Emotion, lust, anger. I will never do. And he promises. At once Krishna believes on him and comes there in a heart, purifies their hearts, make a seat for him, also for Radhika there, and gives pleasure. Otherwise no one. This method don't want money, no problem of money. Whether you are old or young, whether you are girl or boy, whether you are rich or poor, whether you are Hindu, Christian, Isai, Buddha, or anything, you may be. If you call Hare Krishna, Krishna
Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
I think his nature is that he is bound, by nature he is bound to make you happy. And he will take us in his arms. He has done lakhs and lakhs devotees like this. So we must take, we must unconditional take surrender in the lotus feet of that powerful, merciful Krishna. This is the teaching, and this is the warning.
Instructions
of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, also of Vedas, Upanishad, and also of Christianity, what book?
Bible.
Also Quran, everything, everyone tells like this. So in this Kali Yuga, whirling Yuga, Kali means Kalham Lati Iti Kali. Kalhang means to quarrel ourselves is Kali. Everyone is quarreling in family, in countries, in out of country, everywhere. When I came here, it was very hard to come. So, checking in visa and all other things, thinking that they are from other countries. Who has divided? God has himself divided all these countries. I think some 100 or 1,000 years before, India was connected with Australia, also with Africa, to America with Africa, after by growing up sea, anyhow they became divided. But now we are thinking that this is ours, this is there, this all are quarreling. also try to believe in Krishna God. And B, you should give up everything in the Lord's feet of Krishna. Chant always Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Love each other. Try to honor all. Then quarrel. Now devotees are quarreling, what to tell other persons? This is my area, this is your area. You cannot enter in our area. John. You should, we should try that Narayan Maharaj cannot come in this territory. So, we should try to honor each Vaishnava without any creed, caste and creed, no territory at all, not anything. All are in Krishna family, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu family. Thus we can be happy. Gaur Premanande. I want to hear. If you like, you can tell. There are so many Vaishnavas here, qualified, learned. I want to hear something. Because I cannot express my ideas in English. So I want that they should express. You should go. Maharaj can tell. 15 minutes, after that all will
stand up.
Very, very, yes, yes, stand up. With your dand.
Om Magyana Tiranda Sagana Jaya Salaka. Shakshuri Milita Mitasme Sigurna. Devam Divyatram Sushandavadanam Balaira Kachanjitam Sandasana Param Sarika Vairagyam.
No, speak, speak.
Just wait for him.
No, speak.
Oh, do. Anybody who's in Vrindavan can see very clearly, you know, on the street every day. So I don't want to go into this problem of human drama. Because when you think that you have to rub this... everybody is in the same boots, huh? Okay. I'm a practitioner. I have to excuse me because I'm not quite familiar how to address you or how to face you, each one of you. I still am hiding something maybe. But I try to be clear because. because really I'm not here for entertaining you at all. Because I'm a clone of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and maybe also clone of, because life is happiness and a devotee's life is always happiness because atmaramascha munayo nirganta api kurukrame kurvanta hitakim itam bhuta gunahari. What does these words mean? That even the liberated souls, who are, isn't it, Prabhu? Huh? No grudge and no envy. You see, and as we go, you know, because I will go out only when we go for Sankirtana. Sometimes I have to go to Shast. I mean, they buy a bottle of beer, and as long as they're able to digest, that maybe cause some happiness for them. To grab anything she could hold on to and then stuck it in the bag. So rush home, open the fridge, and then suddenly with this out of double experience when a man is completely mad, so we designate him as a madman. So that he has to be treated. And what is the treatment Mahaprabhu came to offer? Because this world is a world of madmen. It's not anybody who thinks that is normal. Everybody thinks that maybe he's crazy. You understand what I'm saying? Because this world is a world of madmen. Because who the hell wants to stay here to experience the sukha dukha, happiness and unhappiness, when there is another world called the world of transcendence? So Mahaprabhu gives the formula that Harinama, 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 Kevalam, Kalo Nasyama, Nasyama, Gati Ranyata. So this is the medicine that we are taking, and it works because, as we see here, the devotees, when they chant so wonderfully, when Guru, who combined all the three together, then the heart became very smooth and very soft. Then we can chant, because then we are lacking teachers. So when you have that guru who himself observing, and not just only theoretically sitting in a yasasan and give a nice lecture, and as soon as you get up the yasasan, or when you come to a guru, what he does also, and how he does it, because we follow the guru footstep. Shri Naramahan Ki Jai.
Om Ajnana Timarandasya Gananjana Salakaya. There's a very well known sloka by a devotee of Mahaprabhu called Vasudev Ghosh, who sang Jari Gaura Nahaita Tabake Haita Kemani Daritam De Radha Mahima Prema Rasa Sima Jagata Janatake. This sloka, he's expressing his deep joy that Mahaprabhu had come into this world. And he's saying, if Mahaprabhu had not come to give this sweetness of love, the highest kind of love for the Supreme Lord, then we would never ever know this gift. We would never ever get a chance to experience this great happiness, this potential that lies in everyone. So he's singing in a very deep way this prayer about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and he delivered this to uplift everyone. And tonight, this is an extension of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's great love for the fallen souls of this age, which Maharaj was just talking about. So, by hearing the pastimes of the Supreme Lord, all the troublesome things in the heart are taken away. And this process is very, very sweet. By hearing about the pastimes of the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna, along with all his associates, all the darkness that's in the heart is taken away. There is one sloka, Bijate Hridaya Granti Chidanti Sarva Shangshaya Kiyanti Chasya Kamani Mai Drishti Kalatmani. Our hearts are tied up, basically, in this world with so many material desires, so many unfortunate shadows have descended on our life. And these shadows are giving us great trouble. But if we take to hearing and chanting the sweet leelas of the Supreme Lord, all these dark things will leave us and go away. And this is the message that Srila Gurudev has come to give us, to have full faith in chanting the Lord's holy name, in hearing his sweet pastimes in Vrindavan Dham, his gorgeous pastimes in Navadip Dham, in Sri Gauranga. So many beautiful leelas of the Lord, he has come to benedict us. He's graced us that we can absorb our minds and give our hearts to these pastimes and become so deeply attracted to him. And by this, by doing this, all the misery, all the dark, inauspicious things that have come down on us, like so many black crows, all these black crows descending on us in the form of bad desires, troublesome relationships, you know, with the world and everyone else, all these bad crows will fly away. Vijate Hridaya Granti Chidanti Sava Shangshaya. So this knot of misconception that we're experiencing in our heart, we can be relieved from that. The knot will be broken and we will come out. Our golden selves will come out and we'll be free to glorify and greet the Supreme Lord. This process is a very deep, beautiful and sweet process. It is given by the Acharyas, Gaudiya Vaishnava Acharyas, and we're deeply indebted for their great effort to come and deliver this to the world, especially tonight. Thank you, Maharaj.
Which Pujyapad Siddhar Maharaj, our Gurudev, and Srila Prabhupada, even Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, always use all these shloks, very important shlok. So I became happy to hear the same shloks with very good meaning, especially Jadi Gauranga Na Hoita, Tabeva Ki Hoita, this written by Rupa Goswami, very important poem. Then if he had not come, who had given that Krishna prem to world, to anyone who came in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Even animals, dog of
Sivananda Singh,
and also other dogs. Even these animals became full of Krishna prem. Even arrogant elephants and tigers playing with deers and sea goats and all others, taking Harinam, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, like this. So he remembered so much things to me, so I became happy. Now, you should tell anyone to speak.
Nanda Kishore Prabhu.
Oh. Shripad Nanda Kishore Prabhu, will you speak something?
So, for the last few days, Srila Narayan Maharaj is speaking some so beautiful siddhant and tattvas he has been explaining to us. So, I feel that the purpose of his visit for myself and the devotee community has been very much to clarify and clear our goal. What is Siddhanta? What is Tattva? So through his very beautiful descriptions, he has been encouraging us constantly to be meditating on the pastimes of the Supreme Lord and the activities of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also. And as we were hearing, he was explaining tonight the miseries in this material world, in this material concept, how we become bogged down with our own external difficulties of carrying this body through this birth. And we, through our material desires, create so many problems and hardships and heartaches and so on. But he's explaining the path across this is to inflame the affection for that supreme Nanda Kishore, that supreme personality of that supreme Brajanandana in Vrindavan Dham. So he has been telling us so many wonderful pastimes of Radha and Krishna, because we can go into meditating on our own internal difficulties, our anarts, for crores of lifetimes, and there will be no answer coming. Just more anats will actually come. There's the new age conception these days. Many people have therapists, etc., psychiatrists and so on, trying to solve their emotional internal difficulties. But there's no answer. Recently I was in England and I met many devotees who had left the main group of devotees, and they were seeking liberation. And Prabhupada speaks in the Bhagavatam that when one becomes frustrated with religion, he will seek liberation. So this is very common at this time, that many people are seeking relief from their sufferings through so-called moksha or liberation. But I've never met anyone who's actually liberated. Many people are trying for many, many years, but there's no fruit in the end, because if the Krishna conception, the understanding that Krishna is the Supreme Lord, is not rising in the heart, if the pastimes of Krishna are not rising in the heart, then just this emotional gross disturbed internal suffering will prevail. So without the presence of the pure devotees of the Lord, the devotees are suffering so much. So I'd just like to take the opportunity to thank very deeply His Holiness Srila Narayana Maharaj for visiting us and distributing this highest Siddhanta. Not just Siddhanta, but the highest aspect of the philosophy we have been able to imbibe in these last few days, which can keep us going for the rest of our lives if we have heard what he has been talking about, these shlokas from Chaitanya Charitamrita. If we can hold that in our heart for the rest of our lives, we will be successful. So we have no way of thanking the pure devotee except by our activities to take those instructions to heart and to endeavor to act upon what he is saying. It doesn't matter so much for running around telling the rest of the world, etc. We have to work on ourselves, and then we will be an example to other people to see what is the fruit of this Siddhanta, the fruit of this knowledge. So I'd just like to thank again Srila Narayana Maharaj for coming.
In Bhagavad Gita it says, Tadvidhi Panipatena Pariprashnena Savya Upadekshanti Te Jnanam Jnaninas Tattva Dashina. So, to approach the spiritual master, we should try to do it in such a way that we are feeling submissive, that we want to render service, and that we want to inquire from such a personality. So this has to be the mood of the qualified disciple, of somebody who is actually sincerely seeking the absolute truth. He has to want to approach such a personality with complete submissiveness, understanding that this personality, he has come amongst us to deliver us out of the darkness of ignorance. So when we meet such a personality, we should try to render service to such a personality. And in any way we can, we should try to please him. And in so doing, then by his mercy, automatically we will be blessed with knowledge and detachment in this world. And from that knowledge and detachment, we will be able to give full concentration to the pastimes and activities of the Lord. And we will become happy, happy within ourselves and happy to understand what we have received by the grace of the spiritual master. So when I first came to Krishna consciousness, I could not understand what the spiritual master was, what is Gurudev. Still, I am very much in ignorance, but I am gradually, very slowly understanding what is the method of getting the mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And that is by pleasing Gurudev. So somehow or other, I am hoping and praying that I can render some little service to Srila Narayan Maharaj and help to, in any way I can, try to push on with the mission of all of the acharyas and learn to become a very qualified instrument in this great mission of Rupa Goswami. Hare Krishna.
Salakaya Chaksurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama Panchakalpatrubhyascha Kripa Sindhuvyevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Nama. First, I offer my unlimited humble obeisances to the lotus feet of both my Diksha Guru A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada and my Shiksha Guru, Srila Narayan Maharaj, simultaneously, and I offer all my humble obeisances to all the assembled devotees. Srila Narayan Maharaj was speaking today about love and the absence of it in this material world. So as he was speaking, I was remembering a class of his that I had attended about 3 years ago in Vrindavan, where he was quoting from Ritrasura's instructions on love, which was later on quoted by Jiva Goswami in his Priti Sandarbha. That is, he gave the example of a little baby bird. And the baby bird is waiting for his mother all day. And finally, at the end of the day, the mother bird comes with a big worm. And the baby bird immediately grabs the worm. So it seems like this is love on the part of the baby bird. But actually, the baby bird, although apparently waiting for his mother, was really waiting for the worm. Then the next example is of the calf and the cow. The baby calf is waiting for his mother cow all day long also. And finally, at the end of the day, the mother cow comes. And the baby cow, with his mouth, grabs the udder of the cow and begins drinking her milk. So this is described by Jiva Goswami as superior love than the baby bird, because the baby bird wanted something outside of the mother. The worm is outside the mother's body. And the calf wanted something inside the mother's body, namely the milk. But still, the calf didn't want the mother, the calf wanted the milk. Then, so the happiness the happiness of love that these two animals wanted was personal happiness, not really taking happiness from the happiness and the loving exchange with the parent. Then the relatively most pure love in this world, the example was given of the wife who's waiting for her husband to return home, and he's very, very late. So she begins to imagine the worst things that could have happened to him. He's taking a train home, so maybe the train derailed. Maybe there was an accident. Maybe somebody hurt him. Maybe somebody stole from him. And she's in complete anxiety, running out of the house, running into the house, asking the children, "Where is your father? He's late." The children don't know anything. They can't reply. But still the mother is asking them. So because nothing actually happened to the husband, he was fine, just some small delay, he came home, and the wife immediately, in great anxiety, sat him down very comfortably, asked him how he was, prepared the, or put down the supper on the table. And this is actually Indian culture or Vedic culture, that the wife is happy in the husband's happiness and distressed in the husband's distress. So this is the most pure kind of love. So in our relationship with Krishna also, there are different degrees. Sometimes we may call something love, but it's actually our personal happiness. Just a couple of evenings ago, Srila Narayan Maharaj quoted from the Madhya Leela, 8th chapter, text number 69, the discussion between Ramananda Rai and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Ramananda Rai explained an example that if somebody is not very hungry or thirsty, then he won't want to eat or drink. Maharaj gave the example that if somebody's very hungry, even if some ordinary food comes, tasteless, no salt, no sugar, no spice, but if he's very hungry, then he'll eat it very ravenously. But if a person is not hungry, then even if so many delicious foodstuffs like halva and pakoras and samosas come, he won't be very interested to take it. So, by a devotee's engagement in devotional service, Krishna becomes pleased. So how is it that Krishna becomes pleased, and why isn't it mentioned that the devotee becomes pleased? This has, as in all verses in the scriptures, many levels of deep meanings. And Maharaj gave a few of those meanings. One is that if the devotee is very hungry for loving Krishna and for serving Krishna, then Krishna becomes pleased to taste that devotee's service. For example, Mother Yasoda is described in the Nectar of Devotion, is the personification or embodiment of motherly love, Vatsalya Ras. She's made of love. Her actual body is made of love for Krishna. So that hunger that she has to make Krishna happy, which even sometimes comes in the form of rebuking Krishna. Sometimes we see those Indian prints, those Brijbasi prints, Mother Yasoda is holding Krishna's ear because he stole some butter or yogurt, and she's very disturbed that he won't grow up properly. He'll grow up to be as naughty as he is now, so sometimes she rebukes him. But her hunger to satisfy him makes Krishna very hungry also. So as soon as he sees Mother Yasoda, he immediately runs and jumps on his lap, on her lap, and takes her breasts in his mouth and immediately begins tasting that love. Actually, everything, just as we sang this song, Munindra Vrindavandite. So one of the verses is that Srimati Radhika, her ecstatic feelings of gravity and ecstasies take the form of diamond necklaces and other ornaments that she wears. So the clothing, the ornaments, even the color hair, the very body of all the devotees in Vrindavan, whereas Prabhupada writes in the Krishna book, is the place where everyone is mad after Krishna and mad after pleasing Krishna. They're all manifestations of the devotee's love. And this makes Krishna very hungry and very thirsty. So another meaning, besides the fact that if the devotee is hungry, then Krishna becomes pleased to taste that devotee's service, is that when Krishna is pleased by the devotee's service, through the happiness of Krishna, the devotee is pleased. Sometimes we think, and Maharaj also gave these analogies around the same time in the same classes as he was explaining what is love and what is priti, that I'm thinking that Krishna must be so pleased with my service to him. I'm doing such a good job. I'm doing such nice service. Krishna must be pleased. So this is not love, and this is not thinking of the happiness of Krishna, but it's self-happiness. And Maharaj gave the example that in India, there was a very poor man, so poor, I forget how much he was making, something very little, like 25 rupees a month, that's less than a dollar. And he had a son who was living far away with his mother, and he was sending about 20 rupees a month to the son, to the mother, with a letter for the son, so that the son could be dressed nicely and go to school or whatever. And he was only keeping 5 or so rupees for himself. And he was sleeping on the footpath, hardly eating anything, very suffering life he was experiencing, lots of misery. But every once in a while, when he got a letter from his mother that his son was doing so well, from the money he was sending, he would tell everybody how wonderful his son is doing, and he would take so much pleasure in that. So we might think that this is selfless love and happiness derived from that love, but Maharaj explained that this was actually his personal happiness. He was just enjoying the fact that he was making his son pleased. Maharaj explained that it's a very subtle difference, but it makes a big difference. It makes a difference between taking birth again in this material world, or living in Goloka Vrindavan, or suffering in the Jiva Dharma. It explains that even activities of neophyte devotional service in Bhaiti Bhakti, following the rules and regulations but without attachment for Krishna, even such regulated activities is a cause of misery. Because even though I'm thinking that I'm doing something to please Krishna, because I'm actually the center of my activities, I have to suffer the miseries of this material world. So love is the highest principle. And Maharaj and Prabhupada both explain from Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur's commentaries in the Antya Leela of Chaitanya Charitamrita in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Sistastikam prayers. Lord Chaitanya is taking the mood of Srimati Radhika, that if Krishna's happiness, if Krishna gets his pleasure from making me unhappy, then that is my greatest happiness. If Krishna prefers some other gopi above me, but for some reason she's angry at Krishna and she doesn't want to go to him, then I would personally go to her house and fall down at her feet and take her hand and bring her to Krishna. Because if Krishna's happiness is to make me unhappy, this is my greatest happiness. This is inconceivable to us at this stage, but it's actually the benediction that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving to the jivas and all of his representatives, beginning from Rupa Goswami down to our Srila Prabhupada and also Srila Narayan Maharaj. So we're very, very lucky to go from the platform of calm or material lust in the name of love for my satisfaction to the topmost love of pleasing Krishna, and then I actually become pleased. Thank you, Panchakobhutrivasa.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
So I'm
indebted to them.
Indebted to you all. All
you. You are the son and the other.
You will have to take these remaining all. And those who have not taken, they should be given. You should take.
Now there's a very nice
Nama Brahmani Vaishnave.